Hello, in this presentation, we're going to record an inventory payment by check and tying that out to the related purchase order within QuickBooks Online. We will have a comprehensive QuickBooks Online course soon, if not available yet. We also have a comprehensive Excel course, which complements the QuickBooks courses, and a QuickBooks Pro desktop version course you can find at the link below. Here we are on the QuickBooks Online dashboard. We will be continuing with the Get Great Guitar problem. We're going to be basically just writing a check for inventory that we had received in the past, but the tricky thing about the check is that we are tying that out and tracking them to the purchase order we had made in the past. Let's take a look at what is going on. To do that, to tell the story, we're going to select this plus icon up top. We're going to go and just look at the vendors section and see what is going on here. What's happening is we already issued a purchase order. Purchase order happened in the past, meaning we asked for a guitar to be given to us. It's a little bit different than if we were to purchase something from Amazon as an individual, where we make the payment at the time that we decide we want to buy something, and then we get it delivered at a later time. In this case, what we're saying is the purchase order has no actual transaction. That's what we have entered in the past, just a request, just a piece of paper, no financial statement being affected when it is corrected in terms of numbers, asking for a guitar in this case, that being the inventory that we are purchasing. And therefore, it's just a request form in essence. We're not going to record the inventory until we receive it, and we're not even going to record the bill because we haven't yet received the inventory. We don't owe anything at this point in time. And of course, we haven't yet made a payment either, which is a bit unusual thing in terms of the comparison between purchasing within a business and purchasing if we're just an individual. That's the thing that could be different, meaning there's a little bit more power, or could be a little bit more power on the purchasing side of things to be able to first get the inventory, check it, verify it, and then enter the bill and make the payment upon receipt. So therefore, we're saying that we have already had this purchase order. We're going to write a check now, and we're going to tie that check out to the purchase order, be able to populate the check through the purchase order we had created in the past. To do that, we're going to say check, we're going to write a check, and we're going to enter the information for the check. Of course, the check means that we're going to be decreasing cash or the checking account. We're going to choose the payee, and we select the drop-down. We typically have the vendors on top. That's what we're guessing would be the normal payees. We're going to say Gibson, so I'm going to type in Gibson as the payee. Tabbing through this, it's the checking account. And we're not going to have a mailing address. We're just going to keep it as Gibson. The date, of course, if it was today, we would have today's date, but we're going to be doing this as of 01/25/21 because we're working in the future for this problem. And the check number should populate automatically. We have the, and we want to match that. Remember, you do want to match that. We want to match that too. If we're writing checks, it should match out with the automatic number, the pre-numbered checks that we're writing. Then if we're going to print them, we would select this print item. And if you print checks, remember, you just can't print checks. We can't print checks just from the QuickBooks system. We have to buy the checks. They'll be pre-printed. They'll already have the number on it. And they won't have then some of the other information like the amount and the person we're paying and whatnot. That's what will be printed on them. And that's going to help be a check against people stealing our checks and whatnot, and making sure that we can track our cash. So note, when we entered Gibson over here, this purchase order item popped up. And this is going to tell us, hey, there's a purchase order right here for this vendor. Do you want to populate this with this purchase order? Should we link these two things? We're going to say, yeah, add that in. And if we scroll down, we see it doesn't populate anything here. So you might get a little worried there. But if you scroll down, it's in the item detail over here. So this is a bit different than the on-ground version where they had two tabs. And it's a little bit easier to see in some ways because you can... if you can miss the tabs sometimes. So now they're listing the items here. This is where we would put normally the expenses if we're paying for the utility bill, the phone bill, or any other type of normal expense, or if we're purchasing anything that would be an asset like supplies possibly, or equipment of some kind. That would go up here, or even if we're paying off a loan payment, anything other than an inventory item. In this case, we have the inventory items. So we can list out the inventory items. Important, because we have to track the inventory items. And therefore, we can't just say it's the inventory account. We need to put it into the subcategory and describe which inventory we are purchasing. In this case, a GSB, which is a Gibson SB guitar. That's what we bought. This is populated directly from the purchase order right here. So we don't have to enter it. It's just going to link it. It's showing that through the little link here, saying that this is linked to the purchase order. So if we think about what this is going to do, and then we record it and verify that it does indeed do what we think it's going to do, as I think we should be doing every time we enter just about anything into QuickBooks. This is a check. So what's it going to do? Well, it's going to decrease cash. It's going to decrease the checking account, clearly. The other side is going to be what? This account? That's not even an account. It's an item. And it's an inventory item. Therefore, we're buying inventory. And so the other side is really inventory. This is really an inventory type account. Inventory item is going to increase inventory by the amount of that $5.98. Let's save it and see if that is indeed what happens. So we're going to go to save and new. And it's saved. It looks good. No red message. So that's nice. Now I'm going to close this out with the X up top. And then we're going to go to the reports, left-hand side, and verify that it does what we think it should have done. Reports is going to be the balance sheet. We're going to look through the balance sheet. That's it. And we're going to change the dates to the dates that we are working on. 01, 01, 01, 2, 1, 2, 01, 31, 2, 1, January 1st, 2021 to January 31st, 2021. We're then going to run that report and we'll go through this and check it out. So here we have the checking account. We'll select the checking account and see if this check is in the checking account. There it is. There's the $5.98. If we select that, then we will see the check that we just created. Closing that back out with the X up top and going back to the main report with the back to report up top here. We'll then choose the other side, which remember was a service item or an item, an inventory item, which is inventory. So inventory should be the other side going up. Here's the inventory. If we select that, then we should see it going up as well from this check. Here's the check. Here's the $5.98. If we select that, then we should see again the check 1005 and the $5.98 down at the bottom. Let's close this back out and let's look at one other area where this should be at, and that should be the inventory listing out. So we're going to go over to reports on the left-hand side and check out an inventory report. So let's go to reports. Let's type in inventory. So we want inventory. And we would like an inventory detail report. So we want an inventory detail. We're going to then change the dates to 010121 to 013121 and run that report. So we're going to run that report. And here is the information. Now we just purchased a GSB. So if we scroll down, we see the GSB here. There's the check that we wrote. There is the amount, and so we have one of those in our inventory items right here.